welcome back to this week's Norman News. I'm Grace Suomi.
And I'm Natalie Gold. Stay tuned for news on the U.S.'s first monkeypox death.
And more on a mass stabbing in Canada. Around the school in 30 minutes,
this is the Norman News.
Hello, Normans. Following up from last week's health report, the U.S. has announced its first death of monkeypox. Last Tuesday, a man in Texas infected with monkeypox passed away. The patient had numerous other health conditions which may have very likely contributed to his decaying health, but this announcement shows the possibility of fatality due to monkeypox to others with underlying health conditions. While most patients infected with the disease are likely to recover within 2 to 4 weeks, recently a study has shown that these timeframes are expanding and the recovery process is increasing in time. Please make sure that you are staying safe and making sure to wash your hands. Have a great week, Normans. Now to Natalie with school news.
Thanks, Grace. BHHS presents Disco Night Homecoming featuring Pitbull's DJ Eddie Boy. Homecoming is on September 24th, 2022 from 7 to 10 p.m. and will take place on the BHHS tennis courts. Entrance is $50 without a go-card and $35 with a go-card. You can buy your ticket at the BHHS Student Store or on the BHHS Student Store website at beverlyhs.myschoolcentral.com. On September 19th, the ticket prices will increase. Normans, you have a chance to win 2 free tickets to homecoming. The homecoming proposal competition is starting now, and you have until September 14th to submit your video. The winner gets 2 free tickets to the disco. Submit your entry videos to ASB at bhusd.com. Now to Jason with more school news.
Thanks, Natalie. Hello, Normans. Do your friends tell you you're hilarious? Have you always dreamed of being an actor? Well, the BHHS Performing Arts are holding auditions for the upcoming fall show titled The Play That Goes Wrong. Auditions will take place tomorrow on Wednesday, September 7th and Thursday, September 8th from 3:30 to 5:30 in the Black Box Theater in Room 207. Callbacks as needed will be held on Friday, September 9th at the same location. For an audition packet or to ask questions, please email Mrs. Howard at showard@bhusd.org. Break a leg, Normans. Now to Eden with international news.
Thanks, Jason. This past weekend, 10 people were killed and 18 were injured in stabbing attacks across the border in Canada. Law enforcement officials are searching for 2 men connected to the crime. The stabbings took place Sunday morning across 13 locations in the James Smith Cree Nation. The number of people with reported injuries rose to 18 on Monday. The police said this in an updated report. Police identified both suspects and warrants have been issued for the arrest of both men. As of now, federal authorities are monitoring the situation. Anyone with any information is urged to come forward. Nada Akira with National News.
Continue to rise to dangerous heat in California, which causes wildfires to grow overnight. In Northern California, the Mill Fire in Siskiyou County almost doubled in size and was burning to an estimate of 4,000 acres with 20% containment. The cause of the fire is still unknown and remains under investigation and evacuation orders for Weed City residents. The Sheriff's Office said that this incident is rapidly changing and our staff and partners are doing everything they can do to get everyone to safety. The Mill Fire is not the only fire that is currently in the county. The Mountain Fire has grown to 3,400 acres with 5% containment. In Southern California, the Roof Fire in LA County was up to 5,200 acres with 71% of containment. The fire department said that their main focus is on mopping up hot spots and furthering containment. Now to Nora with local news.
Akira, at the end of this year, Rochelle Marcus and Gabriel Halimi will no longer be on the BHUSD school board. Although Marcus is currently running for re-election, Halimi has decided not to. Marcus has been in the Beverly Hills community for over 50 years and isn't ready to leave just yet. There are four other candidates running for a position on the school board: Judy Manucherry, Farah Dodes, Michael Amir Salkin, and Janessa Lavois. Manucherry, Marcus, and Salkin all held their campaign kickoffs on August 28th, while Dodes held hers 2 weeks ago. Beverly Hills residents will be able to vote for two people on November 8th. Now to Ariane and Mickey with sports.
Thank you. Hey, Norman Nation, I'm Arya Naeem, and we are back with Pro Sports. Starting off with our local college team, UCLA and USC both dominated their football game Saturday night with a 45-17 lead for UCLA and a 66-14 lead for USC. Looking forward to see them play again next Saturday. Continuing on to Major League Baseball, our very own LA Dodgers won against the Padres Saturday and lost the following Sunday to the Giants, putting them on the top ranked in the West section. Closing off, our local LA Galaxy team tied against Kansas City last Sunday. Wishing them luck against Nashville this upcoming Sunday. That's all for pro sports. Now to Mickey with school sports.
Thank you, Ariane. I'm Mickey Anavim, coming to you with this week's school sports. This Friday, we have our weekly football game against Verbum Day. After two tough losses, hopefully we can break the losing streak and Girls volleyball has a game arranged for the freshmen this Wednesday against Alamany away. On Friday and Saturday, the varsity girls have the Venice tournament. Good luck, ladies. Boys water polo has 3 days of back-to-back games on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Wednesday and Thursday are home games, so make sure you stop by to show support for both the varsity and JV teams. Finally, girls tennis has a game on Thursday away at North. That's all for this week's school sports, and I will see you next time. Go Normans! Now to Deborah with entertainment.
Thank you, Mickey. August 31st, 2022 was the start of the 79th annual Venice International Film Festival, one of the most honored film festivals in the globe. Organized and directed by Alberto Barbera, this festival was held at Venice Lido from August 31st to September 10th, 2022. The event brings attention to international cinemas in all its form and arts and promotes a better understanding of the history of cinema. There are about 21 films competing to win the famous Golden Lion, which is the high prize that could be given, that was introduced in 1949. The Golden Lion is now known as one of the most prestigious and respected prizes in the film industry, with the average attendance being those who are involved in filmmaking and university students who have an interest for filmmaking. The ticket to get in seems affordable, with film screening tickets starting at 15 euros. Now to Tandis with more entertainment.
The weekend concert cancellation. Thanks, Deborah. After losing his voice mid-performance on Saturday, The Weeknd called off a concert in Los Angeles. According to Variety, the concert, which was a stop on The Weeknd's After Hours Till Dawn tour, was scheduled to begin at 9 p.m. at SoFi Stadium. His voice immediately broke when he welcomed his crowd upon entering the stadium, and he only managed to perform four songs before cutting the performance short at around 9:30 p.m. Later, he expressed regret to his followers on Instagram and assured them of a fresh concert. Let's send it to Julia with a field report on the concert cancellation.
I don't know what just happened when I screamed, but I just lost my voice.
Tonight, we're at SoFi Stadium for the Weeknd concert.
He played three songs and then canceled.
This is outrageous. We're gonna go around and ask people what they think about this.
Let's go.
Okay, how do you feel about this situation?
You know, it is what it is, so I don't really care, but he seemed pretty sad about it, so yeah, he's probably really sorry. I took my brother for his birthday to come see this, so it's kind of whack, you know? Not for me, but mostly for my brother, because that's his favorite artist. But also, it's like when you have that much responsibility, I don't know his side of the story, you know, so I don't know what to feel.
How do you feel about the show being canceled?
Honestly, this is so tragic. Like, I was crying inside. Like, yeah, I don't know how to feel. Yeah. Like, I don't know what I'm gonna do, and I don't know if I'm gonna come back here again. So, thank you.
What about the show being canceled?
Well, you know, I was always Puppy Trilogy in sixth grade, so, you know, this is my first time seeing him. You know, supposed to be the night of my life, you know, but I support him either way. You know, I get it, big performer, big performance, you know, takes a lot. So, love you, Abel, you know, take your time, come back strong, and it's open.
Tickets in 2020, so I've been waiting for a long time. So
I am also upset.
This has never happened to us before, ever. It in
never.
Any concert.
And I took a very long time getting ready. So.
Yeah.
How do you feel about the band?
Depressed. Very sad.
Thank you.
Is your lady?
Excuse me. How do you feel about this?
Depressed.
He's depressed. When did you get your ticket?
Like 4 months ago?
4 months ago!
Yeah, 4 months
ago. Oh my god. Let's take a video
set. Where is this going?
Instagram?
Oh, you're gonna be the one.
No, we're famous.
No, just for our high school.
It's for our high school.
You look good. You
high
look
school? Good. I'm a teacher.
Oh, yeah, we are. I am a teacher too, so I probably don't have to stop.
Okay. Sorry.
Thanks, Julia. The upcoming movie named Blonde is an adaptation of Marilyn Monroe's life. This film highlights Monroe's past and how she became the icon she is known as today. The featured film starts with the young Norma Jean and how the adversity she had to overcome to become the legend we know and love today. But the movie shows how Hollywood was not all glitz and glamour and how Monroe still had love issues, exploitation, abuse of power, drug addiction. Marilyn is played by Ana de Armas, which seems like a good choice. To match the 60s feel, most of the movie is shot in black and white, but there are still some shots in color. We will learn the truth behind the mask of Marilyn and who she really is, Norma Jean. The film will be produced on September 8, 2022, but will be released on Netflix beforehand, so feel free to tap in on the actress Marilyn Monroe. Now, let's sit back and relax and enjoy this week's movie trailer.
Miss Monroe, it's time!
A kiss on the hand.
How'd you get your start?
Maybe.
What start?
In movies.
Quite continental. But diamonds are a girl's best friend.
I guess I was discovered.
Men grow cold as girls.
I know you're supposed to get used to it.
And we all lose our charm in the end.
But I just can't.
Square cut or pear shape. These
I've played Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe. I can't face doing another scene with Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn doesn't exist. When I come out of my dressing room, I'm Norma Jean. I'm still her when the camera's rolling. Exists on the screen.
Thank you so much, Delora. Blonde looks amazing, and I can't wait to go check it out.
Go get your tickets for Blonde today. Now let's send it to Julia in London with an interview.
Hi, I'm Julia.
And I'm London.
And we are here to discuss our school cafeteria and student concerns about it. As we are a closed campus, the school cafeteria is the only option that most students here have for lunch. Let's see how a student here at Beverly Hills High School feels about the cafeteria. What are your thoughts on free lunch coming to an end?
I think it's really sad, but I do hope they offer better options of food.
How do you feel about cafeteria lines?
I think the lines are a little too long with a lot of students.
Do you think there could be better options, like healthier alternatives?
Yes, they could offer healthier alternatives.
And how do you believe that the cafeteria can improve?
I think offer better food and let more students in so they could get more food.
Thank you. Lunch.
Thank you, Julia and London. Neon White was the second game to take up all of my time over the summer. Angel Matrix built Neon White with a tagline, "Buy freaks, for freaks." And boy, if this game is anything if not freaky. The game has a very unique style, like if you had Suda 51 make Persona with a side of Bleach, the show, and the chemical. Making for an art style that you're immediately used to, but also something that stands out amongst the crowd. In this game, you play as Neon White, that guy. An amnesiac sinner taken from the bowels of Dante's Inferno by the Believers, a group of humans who took over heaven to purge demons in heaven in an attempt to stay there for an extra year in the 10 Days of Judgment competition. Here he will begin to meet people from his past life, being fellow neons of yellow, violet, red, along with the mysterious neon green. You'll be managed by angels that look like cats, Mikey, Gabby, and Raz, in your demon purging assignments, as you attempt to uncover as many parts of yourself that you can find. Speaking of demon purging, the gameplay is a first-person shooter slash platformer. I would best compare the gameplay to something like Superhot, but if you diagnosed it with severe ADHD. With its clear yet funky environments and FPS elements, it gives the level design a feel very intuitive yet smooth, though there are still quite a few differences. Each level, you will pick up weapon cards by killing enemies that will each have an ammo count and a one-use ability, such as a jump or another form of movement. This is important, as the game focuses on purging and moving as quickly as possible. After making it through a stage, you'll be graded on your speed, getting different ranks depending on how skilled you are, and this is made to encourage speedrunning of the game. While you don't need to go at a specific speed, you'll be processing the environment and learning shortcuts, making the game encourage replayability and aforementioned speedrunning for skilled players. This is all done to the incredible soundtrack by the absolute freaks with a keyboard known as Machine Girl, giving you an excuse to visit each level, or just their Spotify. On each level will be a gift that can be given to a member of the supporting cast, which will make me transition back to the story. Each of the neons has a color at the base of their character, and with just a glimpse of their design, or rudimentary understanding of color theory, you'll be able to put together most of their personalities. White, being, well, the simplest of the neons, is pure of heart and innocent, yet also somewhat empty in a purposefully written sense, while also being very chill and quick-witted. Yellow is a big, buff boy who is characterized by his childlike nature, with his jovial yet really stupid personality, feeling like someone you can just crack open some root beer with. Violet is somewhat of a cutesy punk character with quite violent tendencies, who is like an odd amount of people I know in my own life. Her odd obsession with tattletales should really say it all. Red is passionate and feisty, but also elegant and caring. Green, that guy, is envious and spiteful, but also the most powerful and divine of the neons. All of the characters are given this perfect blend of simple base traits and complexity to expand on in order to get you invested in their interactions and story. Every moment where they are on screen is golden, always entertaining to watch. But what I really wanted to compliment Neon White's story is its themes. It's a game about forgiveness, forgiving yourself for the things you've done, forgiving others for the things they did to you, and being able to live on despite what has happened in your life. A close friend of mine who got me into the game and who I discussed it with over the summer had a lot to express with this theme, and I wouldn't love this game if not for him. With his help, I was able to express what I think was this game's core idea, and in a way I hope you can understand. In life, you and I will hurt people. We'll do awful things to people we love, to people we hate, and we will torture ourselves for doing those things. But you can't change the past. All you can do is make the next day better, and forgiving yourself is that first step to improvement. There are some people in your life who have done horrible things to you, who you'll just want to tell to bite you and leave you alone. But forgiveness is not so that they can live guilt-free, but so you're not tied down by spite. Forgiveness is freedom, and maybe that forgiveness you show someone can be what sends them down the right path. And no matter how awful your scenario is, you aren't entitled to anything, and becoming a righteous person is to be a good person in spite of what has happened to you, not because of it. Because forgiveness does not mean that everything that happened is fine. It just means you are ready to move forward and not let it hold you back. I hope I got across how special Neon White is, but please, play this game. It's really something special. Now to Cammy with this week's restaurant review.
We're called Neons, sinners plucked from hell to do God's dirty work. But I'm finding it hard to believe we're in heaven.
Thank you, Matthew. Hi, my name is Cammy Lady, and welcome to the newest segment in the Norman News, Restaurant Reviews. I'm excited to share my experiences with restaurants all over Los Angeles, and I won't ever hesitate to share my honest opinion with all of my viewers. To start our series, I will be reviewing Crazy Fish. Yesterday, exhausted and hungry after a long day of school and tennis practice, I took a short 5-minute drive from Beverly Hills High School to Crazy Fish, located on Olympic Boulevard in the Beverly Palm Plaza. To start my experience off, I called the restaurant about 5 minutes before arriving and placed my order. The lady taking my order could not understand my name, and when I spelled out C-A-M-I, she heard it as Callie. At that point, I just accepted it and hoped no one else was picking up food for Callie. As I arrived, I headed into the parking lot and found that the only open spot was semi-occupied by a car with an obvious bad parker. I squeezed into the spot and left my car. Something to note is that Crazy Fish is takeout only, with no seating available to you at all. The storefront is tiny, with space for about 4 adults in front of the cash register. I opened the door and waited for about 30 seconds before the lady asked me for my name. I called for an order for Callie, I said. She handed me a bag with my food inside and rang me up. I paid $14 and some change, thanked her, and headed back to my car. I was happily surprised my food was ready so shortly, and the lady was sweet and gave me extra soy sauce, which was always appreciated. Because I could not eat my food there, I drove home, sat down on the kitchen counter, and opened the bag. Inside was my one box of spicy tuna crispy rice, which was all I ordered. For those that are not familiar with spicy tuna crispy rice, it's a bed of rice that's fried to make it stick together, and it gives the rice a crispy texture. The rice sticks together like rice cakes, and it's still warm when served to you. The spicy tuna on top is chopped very finely, almost to a paste. My order was seasoned with raw green onions, fish eggs, and their special sauce. There were 6 pieces. Regarding the price, I'd say it was above average. For a restaurant to not have to pay for waiters and run by one lady and one chef, $14 felt like a lot for me to pay for the small rice cakes. I've gotten 6 pieces for $8 before. However, the quality simply cannot be beat, and I'd argue this is the best crispy rice in the West Los Angeles area. I took a bite, and instantly my mouth was filled with the most delicious taste of the fresh ingredients. Instantly, the $14 price tag was worth it. The textures are impeccable and go so well together. But the real secret has got to be the sauce. Similar to a spicy mayo, it complements the raw fish and rice so well and truly ties the dish together. While this itself isn't a full meal, more of an afternoon snack, it truly is filling. And after finishing, I felt content and couldn't wait for the next time. I didn't end up using any soy sauce because it's not.
Hi, I'm Delery Expert, and I interviewed the student body on 2 games, Truth or Dare and Would You Rather. Let's see what they have to say. Hi, I'm Delery Expert, and I'm here with...
Maorbeer Darien.
Truth or Dare?
Dare.
I dare you to talk with your mouth closed. Thank you. Hi, I'm Delery Extra, and I'm here with... What's your name?
Jasmine.
Truth or dare?
Dare.
Scream your favorite word.
Hello!
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Delia Akhtar and I'm here with
Jaden Mansouri.
Kusha.
Would you rather be rich and not happy or happy and not rich?
Rich and not happy.
Why?
Money will make me happy.
Okay, what about you?
Same answer, because money always makes me happy. Half the time I'm not physically happy in front of people, but when the money comes in, I get happier.
Good answer. With?
Jonah.
Okay, truth or dare?
Truth.
How many selfies do you take a day?
I don't know, like 3, 4.
Hi, I'm Delia Yekfra, and I'm here with
Nathan Yashwafar.
Truth or dare?
Truth.
What is the most embarrassing thing you've ever done?
There was one time when my sack ran out of the house and I was not wearing anything except my underwear. So the guy ran up my block chasing after my sack, and it was very funny.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Hi, I'm Delia Yekfra, and I'm here with
Sebastian.
Truth or dare?
Truth.
If you had a genie, what would your 3 wishes be?
Have lots of money. Get like a Hellcat, which is a car, and then keep the other wish for like later.
Hi, I'm Delia Yekfra, and I'm here with
Mr. Chang, Assistant Principal of Operations.
Truth or dare?
I'll do truth, and if I can't tell you the truth, I'll do the dare.
Sounds good. What app do you waste the most time on?
I play games on my phone.
Okay.
So, kind of like Bejeweled, or there's this really dumb one where like you don't actually do anything. You just like collect players, and the players do stuff on their own.
Oh.
And my girlfriend like yells at me about it all the time.
That's cool.
I'll do a dare too. What do you have?
Do you follow KBEV6 on Instagram yet?
No, but I will, starting right now.
Oh yeah, Brian, I'm here with
Noah Labib.
Truth or dare?
Truth.
What is the most embarrassing thing you ever done?
I once peed my pants at a Clipper game.
Thank you. No, you don't have to be in it. Okay, are you follow KBEV6 on Instagram?
I run the KBEV6 channel. Give me a different one. What the hell?
Jaden Mansouri.
Kusha. Yeah.
And Gazelle Corey.
Oh. Would you rather be rich and not happy, or happy and not rich?
Rich and happy.
Okay, ready?
So professional with this. Oh shit, we're going to the studio right now. Bye!
And welcome to the week of September 5th, 2022 weather forecast. This week in Beverly Hills, we'll see clear sunny skies with temperatures ranging from the mid to high 90s. And today we'll see a high of 95 and a low of 71. Moving on to Wednesday, we'll see skies of 71 and lows of 62. And finally, on Friday and Saturday, we'll see continuous temperatures of 80, but Saturday with a little bit of rain and mid 70s. And thank you for watching this week's weather forecast. I'm Jasmine Rizzotta. Have a sunny week, Normans. Now let's send it back to the desk.
Thanks, Jasmine, and thank you for tuning in to this week's Norman News. I'm Grace Suomi.
And I'm Natalie Gold. We'll see you next week.